Money now doesn't have the same value as money in the future. Why? Because if you had the money now, instead of in the future, you could do something with it. You could invest the money and you would have more money in the future. Let's say you were offered £100 now or £100 in 5 years' time. In 5 years' time, at a rate of 5% per annum, your £100 would become £128. In 5 years' time, you would have £128 or you would have £100, depending on which offer you had taken. Now, I know which one I'd rather have, the £100 now. The concept is naturally called the time value of money. Money now is called present value, and money in the future is called future value. What is particularly convenient about the present value is that it is a consistent point in time, time zero. You can calculate all your cash flows, whatever your project, however many cash flows there are, in terms of present value, and it can help you compare one investment with another. To get from present value to future value is called compounding, and you can use the formula 1 plus the rate to the power of the amount of time. Multiply £100 by this formula and you will get £128. To get from future value back to present value is called discounting, and you can use the formula 1 over 1 plus the rate to the power of the amount of time. Multiply £128 by this formula to get back to the £100. When compounding or discounting, the bigger the rate or the longer time, the bigger effect. In a property investment, you will have lots of future cash flows. You can discount all of them to the present value, add them all up, and this will give you a single figure, which is the present value of the property investment. And this is what is known as the net present value.